What is up, YouTube? Today, we're gonna do a trick tip on burial heel flips because I feel like it's one trick that I see people do, and they could do them, but sometimes maybe they're not consistent at it. My burial heel flips are ugly, but let's get it.
What is a burial heel flip? It's a frontside shove-it with a heel flip. Added together, you get a burial heel flip.
Before we get into the trick tip, you need two tricks down. Frontside shove-it and a heel flip. Those are the two tricks that you need down.
My secret to burial heel flips is if you let your toes hang, that's correct. But if you don't let it hang, you're not going to get a consistent flick out of it. Letting your toes hang, in my opinion, gives you a better consistency on your burial heel flip flicking. But you can keep your feet the way you're not supposed to do it. That's just whatever works for you. That's just what I do personally because it really helps out a lot, man. I highly recommend curling your toes around the board.
So what you're going to do for this is you're going to pop straight down first because it is where people go wrong. And this is what I do sometimes. When I bury a heel flip, instead of me popping down, I try doing both of the motions at the same time. Like I try popping and doing the V heel, which is going to really ruin your V heels, man. So if I were you, pop. And it's not really going to be a scoop. I mean, somewhat of a scoop, but it's going to be a pop scoop. Let's say it like that. Because if you do too much scooping, your burial heel flips might be low to the floor sometimes. Make sure your tail touches the floor, because if it doesn't, then it's probably going to go wrong. So touch at a tiny bit scoop, but not too much. It's going to be more of a pop. I don't know how to say this. It's like go down, but go up. You know what I mean? So if your feet keeps going on the floor, make sure you're not going below. Make sure when you do it, you're going a little bit above. Don't go too above, because if you do that, you're gonna end up turning into a very low hill, so you really don't want that, dude. So
okay, so we're gonna go over the common problems of burial heel flips that I see people do, so let's get it. The number one problem is when the board goes behind you. Honestly, what I would do is whenever I'm doing burial heels, I look at my tail in the middle of the board and kind of look down, because when you do burial flips, you're looking more forward and you're looking down. And not just that, you gotta center yourself whenever you do burial heel flips. Another problem is you're not popping enough, meaning like you can kind of get the motion of it, but like when you're not popping down hard enough, it makes it more harder to burial heel flip. To fix that, honestly, all I can say is get better at your frontside pop shove it to make sure you're popping, because you could get better burial heel flips. When you do burial heel flips, you're not going to be kicking down, because kicking it down is not going to make anything easy. So it's really not the right way to do burial heel flips. But if you're like a beginner, it could be a good start off for you to learn like that, because you're not going to know the timing and the popping and everything like that. So yeah, don't do that. So where do you flick? You know, that's the question. So it's like not in the pocket, but in the pocket, but not in the pocket, because if you go too much in the pocket, you're gonna end up doing dolphin heels on accident probably. I like to just flick in between right there. Another common problem is you have a bad habit of stepping off with your back foot. All I can say, man, is you gotta fully commit, bro. That's all I can tell you. Another common problem is you're landing them, but you keep getting wheeled by and falling. That means you need to go more faster. And you already know them, that's all you got to do.
Like I said, guys, that's all the advice I have for you. This is for people who know how to do burial heel flips, or people who don't know how to do them. But this is just for people who know how to do them and then they just can't get them consistent, man. I really can't go over the common problems because this trick is so easy to me. But like I said, you could do them off of anything. You could just take it wherever, man. Go make your parents proud. Happy 4th of July. And like I said, you already know what I'm going to say, but as a YouTuber, I feel like it's important to be doing this and saying this as a YouTube content creator. Go give this a thumbs up. Go subscribe. I hope you have a good day, guys. So, catch you later.